everyone. Michael Gurley here with my daily blog, my daily podcast. I speak from my blog at michaelgurley.org. Titled this episode, Every Morning is a New Day. For the past few weeks, I've fought with a chest congestion that just does not want to go away, or at least very easily. Yesterday, I thought I had it about licked until I took a mile-long walk and the coughing started toward the end and I had to pull over to a rest stop and catch my breath. Uncle Arthur, arthritis, is starting to make himself known, and sleep is not a luxury I take lightly. If I can get at least 6 hours, then I feel successful. But sometimes it's a forgetful virus that causes me more anguish. Wait, what did I come in this room for? It's during times like this that I'm thankful for the health that I have, and even when it's hard-pressed to keep my stamina up and going, every breath is a welcomed event. If I've learned anything in my 60-plus trips around the sun, being thankful for the little things adds up. The big events are simply boulders that the gravel of my many blessings will cover over. Here's my thought today. Yes, we all have bad news that can ruin our lives, but stopping and smelling the roses can bring a lighter step to our walk. We keep waiting for that other shoe to drop or worrying about what's just around the corner, but if we would learn to start our day in a better frame of mind, then perhaps that boogeyman will not jump out and yell, boo, and frighten us so. I'm tired of the negative always seeming to be the winner. We need to take control of our negatives and allow the positives to gain control. David spoke of Psalms that gives me hope learning how to start off my day better. Psalms 5 and 3. My voice you shall hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning I will direct it to you and I will look up. I believe David learned early, and maybe during his night in the wilds with his flock, that as the morning light gleams over the landscape, let your voice be the first thing God hears in the morning. It should be a thankful sound to him that you're speaking out and looking up. Later, the prophet Jeremiah adds his 2 cents to the concept in Lamentations 3, verses 21 through 26. He says, "This I recall to mind, therefore I have hope. Through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul who seeks him. It is good that one should hope and wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord." Notice, great is your faithfulness. This is speaking of God's faithfulness to man, almost as if you are reminding God of something that he already knows. But by speaking it aloud, you are affirming to your own ears something you believe. Speaking positive to your day every morning. Maybe this is where we all miss it. We dread the day. It's Monday, the traffic, coworkers, the J-O-B, whatever it may be, speak some positive influence to your day. Do it out loud. Let your ears hear your own voice, bring blessings and good words to your day, then go out and make it so. God bless you. Hope you're having a great day.